Hi folks, I'm Andrew, you're watching Prehistoric Australia. Today is my fourth episode of my five-part series about Australia's inland seas that once occurred during the Age of Dinosaurs. For context, go check out my other episodes about the first, second and third inland seas to learn about where the Eromanga Sea came from and which marine reptiles once patrolled it. Otherwise, today's episode is a bit of a short one about the fourth inland sea. So without further ado, let's take a quick dip into the fourth inland sea. By 113 million years ago, the third inland sea had retreated slightly. Sea levels would remain relatively low for another 8 million years. Finally, a new global rise in sea levels once again flooded the southern continent. 105 million years ago, saw the emergence of the fourth inland sea. Marine rocks dated to this time are represented in the Surratt Siltstone of Queensland and the Grimmen Creek Formation of New South Wales. This fourth inland sea was not as extensive as its predecessor because the global sea levels were not as high this time round. This resulted in sedimentary rocks from this time being not as widespread and consequently less fossils being preserved. Only a few ammonites and bivalves have been discovered in Queensland, while a few teeth possibly belonging to Kronosaurus have been discovered in New South Wales. This inland sea was still teeming with life, but proved to be the penultimate hurrah. The fourth inland sea was short-lived. A mere 3 million years later, the fifth inland sea had emerged. Subsequently, the Eromanga Seaway would play out its final act in Central Australia. So ultimately, what happened to Australia's inland seas? Join us next time for the thrilling final chapter, part 5, where you will learn about what happened to the fifth and final inland sea that caused the extinction of life in its waters.